who spent several years on all this on spherical viruses, mostly John and myself. And then we were joined by Tony Crowther, who was trained and he had a degree in mathematics from Cambridge, but he had built a scanner working with David Blow. And he joined us and he put everything on a sound basis, because the way that we used Fourier transform theory to build a three-dimensional image. We sometimes had more projections than we needed. So he introduced what's called least squares analysis to try to put this all together on a regular basis. So we created a new subject, which was image reconstruction in electron microscopy. Now I've gone on quite far ahead because it all was intertwined, and it's hard to go back again and see how the progress came about. But you can sum it up. The reason why it was is we're working on concrete problems, and that I think is pretty important. It's not by, I could have sat down on one afternoon and written out the theory if I'd actually thought that I was going to do it. It's not very, if you know some Fourier transform theory or some X-ray crystallography, you can write down the theory in one afternoon, but it didn't work like that. It took many years to realize what it was that we were doing and how we were doing it. So I do think that's a moral there in science, that these more general principles arise out of particular cases. And I think that's there are other instances of this as well. You study one concrete example of several concrete examples to arrive at a generalization. And that's the way that I think our minds work.